She won't let go of the baby.
What are the prospects?
Not good. Not many will take three together.
Especially not Indians. Too afraid of problems. You have to split them up.
Got an elderly foster mother willing to take them all together, but just for a while.
Did you hear about the real mother?
No.
Nurse said it was the alcohol that killed her.
And we have our lovely neighbors, Ulsa and Steve. Well, there's my favorite son.
Derek, I told you to give this back to Courtney.
Nice tackle, honey.
Ah!
This is for Karen. You got anything to say?
Yeah, I do in just a minute, honey. I gotta get something out of the oven, okay?
Mom,
here, talk to your father.
Dad, he ruined it. I am so sick of him. Tell him to leave me alone and stay out of my things.
Courtney, this is for Aunt Karen. You got anything to say?
Oh, I'm glad that Auntie Karen graduated from business school, and I'm really glad that her and Auntie Tanya moved back in with us, even though I had to give up my room, because they have really cool makeup and clothes. Oh, yeah, and I hate my brother.
Gee, thanks. I'm sure she'll cherish that. Okay, let's see who else we got. Oh, we got two lovely couples over here. My favorite sisters-in-law. Hey, Karen. Hey, you got your MBA. What do you say?
I don't like cameras. Gosh, I just...
Steve, shut off the camera. It's time.
It's time?
Yeah. You guys, I said no gifts.
Oh, it's time.
Ah!
Yes. Okay, everybody. Everybody, can I have your attention, please? It is now time for the official Lakota ceremonial graduate MBA. Great party, Vic.
Yeah, it turned out all right, didn't it?
Mark and his friends still here?
Oh, yeah. Did you see how Mark was glued to Tanya's side all night?
He's in love with her, you know that.
I know, but she's been gone so long.
He'll wait forever.
Well, and it'll probably be forever. She'll never date an Indian guy.
That's so stupid.
Yeah, but then she's not as smart as I am. No.
Is this trash?
Oh, no, Vic will want to save those.
Kitchen.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's okay. No problem. Can't hurt one of these.
What is that? I saw a bunch of them hanging in the house.
Yeah, that's my sister Vicky. She has one in every single room. It's called a dream catcher, and they say that if you hang one over your bed, that all of the bad dreams will get caught in the web, and the good dreams will pass through the hole and to you.
Do you believe it?
I believe in dreams.
That's nice. I'm gonna go in the kitchen.
Oh, that Craig is so cute.
It's right there. Oh, hey, Mark. How did you meet Craig?
Oh, he's my new manager at the nursery.
Oh, is he single?
Hey, I think we got the good job. It is a mess in that kitchen.
So, how much did this cost us?
Steve!
What?
Well, I saved a lot of money by cooking most of the food myself, and people brought some things.
That's great. How much?
Steve Big Hawk, the first time anyone in either of our families graduates from college, you know it's worth celebrating. Hey, what's that for?
So I'm a little confused about the family connections here.
Oh, Steve's my cousin. We grew up on the same reservation in South Dakota.
And you said that was Sioux?
Yep. Lakota!
We all met at Steve and Vicky's wedding.
Oh, was it like a big Indian ceremony?
Oh, no. It was just a wedding. We were bridesmaids.
Is that like a really stupid question?
No. Not for a white boy.
And you said that your family is Sioux also.
No, actually, Actually, it's a really, really long story and kind of boring. Here, would you take this? Would you come and help me with this?
Sure.
Thank you.
Barbecue, we need your stuff.
Here, let me see your hand.
Well, what is that?
Trust me.
Sorry about that, Craig.
No, it was my fault.
I'm surprised it was still that hot.
I wasn't looking. It's amazing.
Fixed pretty good with that stuff.
No, I mean, it just stopped hurting like that.
And I'm going to give you a baggie of it to take home. If you keep applying it, it'll stop the blistering as well.
Thanks, Mom. Should market this stuff.
Yeah.
Are you sure your hand's gonna be okay to drive home? I could drive you home.
I came with Mark.
We'll walk you out.
Thanks, Vicky.
Oh, you're welcome, Craig.
Great party.
Thanks. Nice meeting you.
Same here.
Craig's a pretty nice guy.
Yeah, he is.
What are you looking for?
Corkscrew. I thought we had one back here.
Corkscrew?
Yeah, someone brought us this hostess gift. I'm gonna have a glass.
No.
No?
That's not a good idea.
Steve, I'm not one of the children. You don't have to talk to me like that.
Okay. I would rather you didn't.
I was talking about having one glass.
That's not the point. The point is we should not argue about this again. Please.
I'm not saying I agree with you. Hey, you're improving. You waited 5 minutes this time.
What?
The remote usually takes you about 30 seconds before you reach for it.
I'm just holding it. I haven't turned the TV on yet.
Ah, okay. Well, that's extra credit. Hey, don't forget, you gotta be up about 5 tomorrow morning.
Where am I going again?
School field trip, whale watching.
Right. Your hair's so soft.
Hey, Steve?
Hmm?
You know, I was thinking about something.
Hmm?
Did you hear what Craig said tonight about possibly marketing my, Steve?
It's a great job. It's just not really my first choice. Anyway, I have to let them know in 2 weeks.
And where is this job?
It's in, Chicago.
Chicago? What?
Chicago.
You mean I finally get our family back under one roof again, and now you're gonna be leaving just like that?
I have to work, Vic.
So if this job isn't your first choice, what is?
Well, I did my graduate thesis on the subject
of... Oh, jeez.
What?
I don't know, that just sounds so grown up. My graduate thesis. I've never done anything that sounds that grown up.
You gave birth to 2 10-pound babies.
No, Courtney was 9 and a half.
Vic, what are you doing?
I'm making a pot of coffee. So keep going. You did your thesis.
On the efficacy of entrepreneurship.
Oh, can you spell that?
Who cares about spelling? What the heck does it mean?
It means owning your own business.
Didn't you already drink a whole pot?
For your information, Miss Beauty, sleep until 10. I had to be up at 5 this morning. The kids had a field trip.
Ooh, sounds like fun. Where to?
Oh, they went to be experimental subjects at the radiation lab at UCLA.
Hmm. Vic!
No, they went whale watching. Steve's with them. So, Karen, I'm not getting this. You're telling us you did your thesis on one thing.
Something we can't pronounce.
Right. And yet you're considering a job you're not really thrilled about.
Yeah. Does not compute. Does not compute.
I need a real product. I used a theoretical one in my thesis, and it's a great plan, but to start a business, you
Wait,
need...
Wait, what did you just say?
It's a great plan.
No, no, before that.
She needs a product?
Come on.
What?
Let's go. Let's go. Come on.
Follow me.
Vic, you're still in your jammies.
Come on.
My cereal's gonna get soggy.
Ow. Gosh. Where are we going?
Would you slow down, please? Do you remember Mrs. Knutson? She always had that vacant lot.
She's still alive?
She sure is, and she lets me use it.
Use it for what?
Wow!
You did this?
Yep, last 4 years. Over here, I've got some tomatoes and some red cabbage, and look at the size of my eggplants.
Wow. Yeah, Vicky, this is all really great and everything, but you dragged us down here in your pajamas to show us eggplants?
Do you remember when I finally found our real dad and I spent some time with him on the reservation?
Vic, please don't go into that whole guilt trip again.
You know we couldn't be there.
No, listen. He taught me things from the earth, lotion, shampoo, medicine, some really amazing stuff. Come here, take a look at this. These are the herbs. Herbs are, well, they're really powerful. What if we had a product?
He healed a woman with diabetes using greasewood plant. And this one has willow bark for pain.
Look, Big, it's really not a bad idea, but medicine is such a touchy area. And you've got malpractice, lawsuits, just...
Ooh, that's all we need.
Okay. Come with me.
So what is this?
Yucca plant shampoo and conditioner. Indian women have used this for centuries.
Shampoo, huh?
And it works as good as the real stuff?
I'm telling you guys, it works better.
So, do you have the formulas for these?
Well, I wouldn't really call them formulas, but Dad and I wrote them down in a notebook.
And can you make them in large quantities?
Sure, I guess.
Mm-mm. It won't sell. People want their beauty products from Europe. They want to look like a French woman or get something from a Swiss spa.
People want what works, Sissy.
Tonya, I cannot believe you just said that.
What?
Why do you try so hard not to be an Indian?
Why do you try so hard to be an Indian?
Oh, well, maybe because I am, and so are you, last time I checked.
You guys, this might work.
You really mean that? Honey, when's your poker game this week?
Tomorrow.
And it's here?
Mm-hmm. Why?
Would you mind if we kind of use the kitchen at the same time? We need to try out some of the recipes. You know, Karen and Tonya and me, we've been talking and we think that... Steve?
I'll, hold.
Raise your two.
What?
I fold. He's bluffing. I'll, match you and call you.
Oh, man. what happened to the look of the Irish, huh?
Custer took it all with him.
Yes.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Not bad. I just lost everything.
Oh, no, no, no. I just plugged in all the information Vicky gave me, and I have our projected expenses.
Four?
Well, we only need $25,000 for our initial startup.
Ooh, only $25,000.
Have a garage sale, Vic's closet.
Oh, that'll get us 25 cents.
Okay, Tanya's closet.
Hey, who invited you into this conversation?
What are you guys talking about?
Vic, she gets these ideas.
Oh, Craig's all for it.
I am?
Yeah, you actually suggested it.
I did?
Don't ask questions. We've learned.
Hey, Vic, what's that smell?
Oh, it smells like old shoes.
Oh, you are far too polite. That smells like somebody cut the cheese, laid an egg, shot a bunny.
Ew. Hey, we're not finished yet. You guys, this is very doable.
Seriously?
Yes.
Call me when you get the 25 grand.
Well, for your information, favorite brother-in-law of mine, I made us an appointment tomorrow at the YEA.
Yeah,
what?
See?
The who, hey,
okay,
hey?
Okay.
Hey. The YEA, it's a government agency that gives grants and small business loans to minorities and women.
Hey, and we're both!
So I've been through the entire proposal, and let me say first about the business plan that you've done some great work. The research, the budget, the marketing strategy all seem very solid.
Thank you very much. I put it together in business school.
Uh-huh. Well, the weak link may just be the market you've chosen to enter, because cosmetics and health and beauty aids are usually dominated by big conglomerates, you know. Although, one of them may take an interest and want to absorb you.
We don't want to be absorbed. We feel like our line is unique from the other products.
You see, it's American Indian remedies and formulas that have been passed down from our elders.
It's the real American thing.
Right. Well, I'm glad you brought that up, because normally your proposal would be an easy one for us to fund. Native Americans are the smallest percentage of our recipients, and being female and Indian would usually make it quite easy. But, and you're very enterprising.
Cut the crap, Mr. Carlson. What seems to be the problem here?
Vicky.
No, that's okay. See, our regulations stipulate that you must be federally recognized through the BIA. That's the Bureau of...
Indian Affairs, yes, I know.
And your application says that you are California Indians.
That's right. Our mother was from the Morongo tribe, and our father was Viejas Band of Kumeyaay. They're both considered Mission Indians. It's just that the Kumeyaay now use their native language.
Right, but you showed no enrollment numbers, tribal or CDIB.
CDI what?
CDIB, Certificate of Degree of Indian Blood. It's a document issued by the federal government.
We don't have one of those, Mr. Carlson.
We were adopted as children. We have no access to our birth records.
Yeah, our real parents are dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But we were raised on the reservation until I was 7. Karen was 4, and Tanya was born there.
And then you were raised by a non-Indian family.
Yes. So does that make us non-Indian?
Well, no, but the state law does. I mean, I'm not saying that I agree, but unless you can show that you are a member of a federally recognized tribe, we can't do anything.
Mr. Carlson, how many ethnic minority groups do you recognize here at the YEA?
5. African American, Asian American, Hispanic, Pacific Islander, and Native American.
Uh-huh. And how many of the other ethnic groups have to prove who they are with a number?
Well, I think... Well, obviously...
No need to answer, Mr. Carlson, because you and I both know that none of the others do.
Vic.
In fact, Mr. White-ass Carlson, I guarantee that you will never have to prove who you are with a number.
Vicky, maybe we should go.
Do you realize when the last time a group of human beings had to be numbered and labeled? It was in the German Holocaust when the Jews were categorically numbered and then executed. And you know something, Mr. Carlson? I feel that you and this YEA-BIA bullshit policy is trying to do the same thing to me and my sisters right now.
We might be able to put you through as Hispanic.
Oh.
I'm trying to help you. You know, I understand.
No, no, you don't understand. How could you possibly understand?
Vicky, come on, let's go.
And let me tell you something. You know what? My kids are going to get the same treatment from the next guy and the next, because you'll never understand. You're all a bunch of hypocrites.
Do you want to try the Hispanic approach, Miss Lewis?
No, I don't think so. We're not Hispanic.
Okay, I'm sorry. If you want to kick me out of this business, I'll understand.
Look, we're not going to kick you out of the business, but you embarrassed me today. That was not Mr. Carlson's fault. He did not write the policy.
Do you even realize that the Bureau of Indian Affairs falls under the federal government Department of Interior? It's the wildlife and the fish, the forests, the parks, and the Indians. What do they think we are, a bunch of damn trees?
Save the trees. Maybe we'd have more protection as trees.
Maybe you shouldn't have cussed so much.
Mom cuss?
Not really.
A little. What'd you say?
Nothing. Did you finish your homework, honey?
Except for my spelling. Can you test me?
Sure, honey. Sit down. Thank goodness I have a couple of other contacts.
But what about that guy at the YEA? Should we, like, file a complaint?
Harmony.
H-A-R-M-O-N-Y.
With our legal system, he could probably sue us.
Equality.
E-Q-U-A-L-I-T-Y.
Harassment or something.
You know what? Forget the YEA. We don't need them.
Hopeful.
H-O-P-E-F-U-L.
Are you sure? $25,000.
Persist?
P-E-R-S-I-S-T.
Well, I have this woman's card. I don't know what she does, but I met her in business school.
Obstacle.
O-B-S-T-A-C-L-E.
Good, honey. Anyway, I sent her our business plan, and she seems interested, so we'll see.
Well, hopefully she'll be nicer than Mr. Carlson.
I think she'd have to be. Visionary.
V-I-S-I-O-N-E-R-Y?
A-R-Y.
Nice shot. Learned that in business school?
High school.
Pretty good.
City champs.
Wow.
Where did you learn how to play?
Oh, I guess Steve would say Custer taught me.
Steve and his Custer jokes. Hey, where are the guys anyway?
They went to pick up some dinner.
They're kind of taking over the kitchen, huh?
A little bit. Hey, by the way, I want to offer my help.
Really? How?
Your business. Eventually, you guys are going to run out of plants. I own this plot of land. I let flowers, plants, herbs grow wild on it. I'd love to show it to you.
Craig.
What?
Are you offering to help me with my business, or are you asking me out on a date?
Busted. I'd like to show it to you, but I would love to take you to dinner.
You know what? Honestly, I'm going to be so busy with the business for the next 2 weeks.
I can wait 2 weeks.
I'll tell you what. Sink it, and you're on.
Well, that's a pretty low-risk bet on your part, considering I've missed every one today. Two weeks.
A date? I can't believe you did this to me.
What are you talking about?
Like you couldn't tell I like Craig.
Oh, please, sissy. You only flirt with every guy in the Western world. How was I to know Craig was any different?
What do you want with him anyway? Last I heard, you were the world's oldest virgin. Or did you lose that in business school?
Look, I was just considering going out on a date with the guy, okay? I wasn't gonna marry him. Besides, what about Mark?
Mark is not my type.
What does not my type mean?
I don't know, he just isn't. His job isn't.
He and Craig work at the same place. Is this because he's Indian?
What do you think? What did being Indian ever mean to us anyway, huh? I mean, our mom was a drunk, our dad was dirt poor, we were lucky to even be adopted by our foster mom because nobody wanted three Indian children together anyway. Sounds great, doesn't it?
Okay, but sissy, there are alcoholics and poor people and children who get adopted from every race.
I'm not talking about every race. I'm talking about us, our race. Indians are poor.
Vicky says there's a casino on our reservation now, and our tribe doesn't live in poverty anymore.
Fine. But I bet Craig's family has his own crust in tartan.
I bet you he can trace his heritage back to the 1300s. And he doesn't have to have a number to prove it.
Listen to yourself! Is this about me stealing, Craig? Or is this about family heritage?
Look, Sissy, what's really going on?
Nothing.
Look, I'll tell Craig that I'm just...
Forget Craig.
This business, I want to help, but...
What?
Just makes me think of too many things. I know what happened to our real mom.
Sweetie, we all know what happened to our real mom.
Don't act stupid! Everybody talks about how she died from alcohol, but I know she died giving birth to me.
No. No, Dad said her organs were ruined from alcohol. Her liver and heart were destroyed from all those years of abuse.
But she died from the strain of childbirth.
Don't try to change it. You were so small. They thought you wouldn't make it, that there'd be something wrong. You know what, Tanya? God made you perfect. And you turned out to be the prettiest.
And the most talented.
Yeah, right. Hey, you know what? I'm way too busy to date. Look, you can have him. I'll just tell him, you know.
No. I don't want him. You can have him. Besides, he likes you.
All right, who likes who?
Oh, no one.
Hey, I came to check out your closet. Nothing business-looking fits me anymore after having two kids.
Vic, you look great. You're the same size as you've always been.
And God gave you the better boobs. Better than either of us.
Hey, breastfeed two kids, your boobs will get bigger, too.
Gotta have a husband first.
You know, the kids are saying their bedtime prayers. Why don't we put in a few requests? A man for Tanya, smaller butt for me, and for Karen. A mere $25,000. Should be a piece of cake for God.
Are you sure this is it?
I don't know. The card just has a name and an address. It doesn't say anything about her being a
psychic.
Hey, as long as we're here, maybe she can tell your future, Tanya, find that man you've been looking for.
Karen, is that you?
Oh, Celeste, hi.
So nice to see you.
You too.
Again.
These are my sisters. This is Tanya and Vicky.
Welcome. Hi. Very nice
hi.
To meet you. Come on in. Sit down.
She seems normal.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that you called me. You know, we were so busy at school, we just never seemed to have time to connect. But it's the oddest thing because I had a dream about you the other night.
Really?
Yeah.
I had just been to the sweat lodge and my talking medicine circle.
Wait. You're in a talking medicine circle?
Oh, yes. You know what? I think we better burn some sage before we begin. Are you an Indian?
Yes, I was.
Does that mean you got a divorce or something?
No, I was in a previous life.
Oh. Well, did I tell you that Celeste and I met in Women in Business Association at school?
You know, the minute that I saw you, I was drawn to you. I knew we'd be drawn together. It's true. I guess, you know, the spirits of our ancestors.
Excuse me. What kind of business is this exactly?
I help people. I've been empowered by the spirits, and so I help others with my gifts.
Oh. So, did you get a chance to look at our business proposal?
Mm. It's wonderful. I think we can really help each other. The minute I read it, I said, yes, yes, we are all on the same path to heal and to bring wholeness to the lost, and I think I'm going to be able to help you all find your funding.
Really?
How?
Well, I've been asked to put together a special Sundance ceremony and vision quest. My clients are in need of special healing, so I've been asked to take them on this special journey and to perform their naming ceremonies.
Would you be charging them for this ceremony?
Oh, yes, of course, because, you know, I have to maintain my business and provide for myself, but money really isn't an issue with my clients. They're very, very wealthy.
Oh.
And that's where you come in.
Well, see, we weren't actually raised with our tribe.
Oh, that's fine. Doesn't matter. I need you all to help me enrich the authentic energy of the ceremonies. I will pay you a small fee, but the opportunity for you is going to be in finding your funding from my clients. Oh, I know they're going to be interested. Very supportive.
Well, see, I don't know because...
Well, we're Presbyterian. Oh, that doesn't matter. It's fine.
No, actually, it does matter. You see, we walk the Christian path, but we also embrace our Indian traditions. My husband comes from a very traditional Sioux family, and we embrace and honor our Indian traditions.
Of course you do.
Vic,
No. You don't seem to understand. This and this, they're sacred to my husband and to his family and to the Lakota people. The prayer, the ceremony, it's not for sale. Don't you charge for any of this. Just don't. I need to go now.
So, you read palms?
Vicky told me about that woman today. Bad stuff.
I didn't swear this time.
No, but you were rude again.
You know something, Karen? Lakota spiritual leaders are chosen very carefully. It's a great privilege, but it comes with even greater responsibility. Now imagine if your friend suddenly decided to call herself the Pope and started charging people for their confessions.
You're right. I understand. Actually, you know, I knew the meeting wasn't going well when the woman remembered that she was Indian in a past life.
Ooh, I thought I recognized her from somewhere.
Oh, hey, Courtney, Derek, come set the table for dinner.
Back to work, you guys.
I got the kids.
Hey, this feels good. It tingles.
Really? You can feel it tingle?
Yeah, a lot.
Woo! It's really hard to get this one just right, but that means it's working. We really did it.
Right on.
So what's next?
Well, I have a couple of leads to follow up on, and in the meantime, we just keep working on the products.
So Karen, on this one, we want the whole plant, root and all. Now see, our products are actually from the earth. Other products say they are, you read their label, and they're really not.
Exactly, so when we market our line, we've got to do it in a way that the consumer knows that they're getting the real deal.
We just need the right words.
Right, like a natural, healing, Earth, native,
profitable. Oh, shoot, I gotta run.
What?
Well, Steve got called into the job site today and Derek has baseball tryouts.
Vicky, we committed to being here all day.
Yeah, I did commit, but I have to live in reality, Karen.
Okay, see, I don't know anything about this. You're gonna have to stay here.
It's okay. I'll take Derek.
All right. He needs his glove and his baseball hat.
Okay.
Oh, and Tanya, his cleats. They're in his closet. Remind him to put the cleats on.
Okay.
back to work.
Tanya, how were tryouts?
Oh, great.
Just great? Did they have him throw and hit? And what about the fielding?
Oh, he was hitting good. He's so cute. I think he was the best looking kid there.
What? I have 18 emails? Hello, I'm 32, single, and love exotic women.
Ooh,
that's for me. Oh, I got an answer.
Tanya?
No.
What? Jamie met her husband on the internet. She says it's a great way to meet guys who are your intellectual match.
I think they're just geeks who can't get dates anywhere else.
No, there are lawyers, accountants, brokers, film critics.
Psychos.
Sissy, this is not a good idea. It's okay. Why do you guys always treat me like I'm 2 years old? Oh, look, he collects stuffed animals too.
What's it called?
Purple coneflower. We used all of Vicky's.
I don't think we carry it here, but nope. Hey, you know what though? It grows wild on my property.
I bet it does.
What, you think I'm just trying to get you up there to seduce you? It's not my style. I'd at least take you to dinner first.
Hey, you know, I need to talk to you about that.
About seducing you?
About our date.
Our date? Oh, wait till you see what I've got planned. We're gonna go out to Malibu.
I can't go.
Why not?
I'm just very busy right now.
It's one night out.
I know, but...
You're not interested?
No, that's not it. It's just...
You only date Indian guys? Is that it?
Of course not.
Well, then what?
I'm just very busy, and, you know, maybe we can do it another time.
No, we don't carry it here. Maybe Sherman Oaks.
Well, okay, thanks.
All right.
See ya.
See ya.
What's going on? Who's on the phone?
After the YEA said we needed those roll numbers, I thought I'd open my files again. Call some more places.
And
the laws have changed. They actually gave me the location of our birth record, some archival center.
That's great.
No, it's not great, Steve. A very polite woman just informed me that all California Indian adoption records from our agency prior to 1975 were destroyed in a fire. There's nothing.
Vic, those records, the files, that's not who you are. They're just pieces of paper.
Oh, Steve, that is so easy for you to say. You're a card-carrying Indian from a well-known family. You can't possibly understand what it feels like. Who am I, Steve? It's like I don't exist.
Craig?
Yeah?
Tanya likes you, and she felt like I was kind of moving in, and so I told her I'd back off.
Tanya? That's absurd. I thought she and Mark were...
I know, we always throw them together, but she's not really interested.
Well, that's too bad.
Yeah. So...
So, it still doesn't make any sense. I mean, can you tell me you don't feel anything?
No. I can't tell you that. It's just that, you know, Tanya's so fragile, and I just really don't feel like I can hurt her right now.
Okay, forget about the date. Business only. I've got your plants, strictly professional.
I'll think about it, okay?
Okay.
Vic, do you ever think I'll find the man of my dreams like you did?
Tanya.
No, I mean, come on, really. Did you and Steve marry because you really, really loved him then? Or because he was really, really Indian and then you grew to love him?
What the heck is that supposed to mean?
I don't know. Tell me about when you and Steve met. I love that story.
Well, I had just graduated from high school. You were still in elementary. And I didn't know what I wanted to do. I thought I wouldn't get married for a long time.
And then that summer, my best friend Ashley, her family invited me to a powwow. They thought we went all the time. I didn't tell them it was my first one. When we got there, I heard the drumming and the singing, and I just started walking towards it. Later, Ashley's dad yelled at me. He thought we got kidnapped or something. But that drumming, the drumming was so powerful. I felt like it was just calling me home. When I got to the circle, there were about 30 dancers there, maybe more. But all I could see was this one dancer, one fancy dancer in this incredible regalia. And he was dancing as if no one else were around. And the drumming and the singing, it blocked out all else in my mind. I just stared at him as if I were hypnotized. And then he looked up and he saw me watching him. He walked over to me later, and I said, "You are the most beautiful man I have ever seen." He teases me about it all the time now.
That is so romantic.
Yeah, Tanya, it was romantic, but it just happened.
I don't believe it'll ever just happen to me. Nothing happens to me.
Oh, right. I don't see me dancing and singing on some stage or my name on any marquee.
But that didn't just happen. I mean, I worked really hard for years. Went to auditions, classes, lived in a pit with five other girls, being told I'm too skinny, too short, too flat. I mean, I tried really hard, Vic. Real hard. And it didn't happen. I failed.
Tanya, no. If you're a failure, what am I, huh?
You have a family, a husband, people who need you every day, who love you no matter what. Is it wrong that I want that too?
No, Tanya, you're not wrong to want that. Why don't you just give the creator a chance? You have your own path. You need to be happy with who you are right now, not wait for anything to happen. Maybe you'll find a man, but maybe not. Maybe our business will take off and we'll be hotshot businesswomen. Who knows?
Who knows? Who knows?
Stuff.
Yeah.
How can I help you, ladies? Oh, hey, Vicky, how you doing?
Hey, Joe. Oh, this is my sister, Karen.
Well, the looks sure do run in your family. Are you both Lakota like Steve?
No,
we're California Indian, Morongo and Kumeyaay.
Well, California Indians, thank you for allowing us on your land.
Oh, Joe.
Hey, there was a lady just here from the mission band of Viejas, Kumeyaay.
Really? That's our dad's reservation.
Well, I'll go get her so you can meet her.
That'd be great.
I'll be right back. Mom can help you.
Thanks.
Guguch, Bialo, Nyawe.
Hey, maybe she knew our dad.
Yeah. Hi. We're looking for five herbs. Here.
Excuse me. Are you two the ones saying you're Viejas?
Oh, yeah, you must be the...
I'm Connie. I'm an enrolled member of the tribe. Just want to know if I knew your family. So what's your last name?
Well, I'm Karen Lewis, and this is my sister, Vicky Big Hawk.
Lewis? Big Hawk? Those names aren't from my tribe.
Oh, no. You see, what happened is...
See, we were...
Listen, I'm telling you this for your own good, to save you some trouble. We have a successful casino now, so everybody's wanting to join the tribe. When we were on welfare, no one wanted to then. It's probably not even your fault. Someone tried to make you feel good. Glamorize your heritage, wear your hair long. You know, Say you're Indian.
What?
You say it to the wrong people, and you'll get yourself in trouble. People are coming out of the woodwork now. I'm just trying to be helpful, give you some good advice, you know?
Wow.
What was that all about?
Oh, no, no, come on, we're going after her.
No,
she
Vicky,
cannot
Vicky,
talk
no,
to
no,
us
no,
that
come
way.
On, calm
I'm gonna
down,
tell her our
Vicky,
dad's name.
Look, calm down. It's not gonna do us any good to run after some lady at a powwow and get in an argument, okay? Look, we can prove who we are. We'll just go through the proper channels. We'll get our birth records, okay? Come on, let's go. Yeah.
Four stories, one prayer, one scolding for bouncing on the bed, and the kids are finally asleep.
Oh, I was just reading the label.
Why?
It says it has a light and fruity bouquet.
We shouldn't even have that here.
Why not?
You know why not.
No. No, I don't. I have the right to a glass of wine now and then.
And your real mom, that she have a right to drink herself to death?
How can you talk about my real mother? You never knew her. You couldn't possibly know what demons she might have been fighting.
You're right, I can't. And neither can you, and neither can your sisters, and neither can our children. As a matter of fact, they will never know their grandmother because of that.
Steve, I am not an alcoholic.
You've been drunk a few times.
Hasn't everyone?
No.
You and your family are different. You made a choice not to drink. It doesn't mean that I can't.
Vicky, you did not grow up on the res. You did not see the things I did. It is not just a spiritual choice. It's a goddamn reality.
I just want to be like everyone else. I have a hard day, Steve, a lot of responsibilities. I want a glass of wine. And you know something? If I were Caucasian, no one would think twice about it. But because I'm Indian, oh, no, you better not. Well, do what you want with it.
No, you do what you want with it.
Fine. What?
Nice top.
What?
I think you look good.
Yeah, right.
Why is that so hard to believe?
Steve, I don't feel particularly sexy right now.
Why not?
Gee, I don't know. Maybe it's the yellow plastic look.
Trade it in for black leather.
Oh, yeah.
I mean it. We've been married 15 years and you have never...
Never what?
You know.
Worn black leather?
Leather, silk, satin, corset, garter.
Corset, garter? Steve, this is mommy here, not some beach babe.
I think you'd look great.
You mean that? Garters? You're serious?
Yeah. You're my wife. It's legal.
I'll think about it.
Oh, you guys, I made us an appointment.
Yay!
With who? Executive Management and Limited Partners. It's a private investment firm and they give small business loans.
And we don't have to have numbers?
I don't think so. But they do want our incorporation papers, and I have those. Except, you guys, we don't have a company name.
Hey, I already told you. Come into my TP Therapeutics.
Mark!
Not funny. This smells good.
That's the chamomile and aloe vera. So, Karen, what were you thinking exactly for our company name?
Oh, you know, like we talked about before, something natural sounding.
Mother Earth?
Native Earth?
Yeah, keep going. Think holistic. Maybe something whole.
Holer.
Whole. Native whole.
Native whole. What kind of business you guys starting?
Would you can it, you two? My goodness. Well, I'll tell you one thing. We're going to have to work on the packaging. This is Steve's aunt's jam jar, complete with a rusty lid.
Yeah, you're right.
I don't think we should change it.
You don't?
What?
Hold on to that thought.
Vicky, packaging is so important. We're gonna have to change it.
Maybe she likes the rest.
She would.
Hey, where's Courtney and Derek? It's too quiet in here. Steve, where are the kids?
Went to the movies with Tracy's family.
On a school night? Did you do their homework with them first?
You weren't here. I said they could go. You ready, bud?
Well, I have grown quite attached to it, but I guess.
And he cooks, too. Yuck. I love you.
Look, what do you have?
So, they're all glossy, fancy, manufacturing, but it fits right into their labels. Chemicals and additives.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. This is perfect.
Aunt Mona's rest?
Oh, no. But, you know, the idea. You know, the homemade feel, like you just went out into your own garden and picked the ingredients yourself? Tanya, this is brilliant. You're brilliant to meet our new marketing director.
Well, hey, what about me? I put it in the old jam jar.
Fine, you get two brownie points.
No, I was thinking stock options.
Hey, you're learning.
So when is our meeting? Tomorrow?
Yeah. You know what, you guys? I feel really good about this one. You know, it can't go any worse than the last two, right?
Yeah. Let's just hope they don't say anything to get Vic mad.
Okay, come on, guys. All right. How's this? I promise to remain absolutely silent tomorrow. No matter what anyone says to me, not one word out of my lips. No lecturing, no cussing. I'll just let you two do all the talking.
Whoa.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
Ladies, I'm sorry about the interruption. Mr. Douglas is still on the conference call. Can I get you anything? Coffee? Water?
I'll take some coffee.
Water, please.
Nothing, thanks. Great, I'll be back.
Thank you.
Was it something I said to him?
No. We just introduced ourselves. Listen, everything is going to be great.
It's just that we're low priority. We need him, he knows that, so we can wait. Oh, you're right. I did promise, didn't I? Okay, not another word.
Oh, my apologies, ladies. That call took a little longer than I expected. Now, let's see. Where were we?
Our business plan. I was explaining how all of the formulas and the recipes come from our father.
Right.
But before we go any further, we need to be honest with you. We were adopted as children, and we don't have tribal enrollment numbers or CDIB cards.
What's that?
The government, they give us these little...
It's their form of recognition.
Oh, I'm not concerned with that. You are descendants of these two California tribes, the Morongo and the Viejas, right?
Yes, we are. Now, back to our products. They are a new and, more importantly, effective line of herbal shampoos and
It's not the product that concerns me. The problem relates to a moral and ethical issue raised by my associates.
Herbal shampoos are very tame.
We don't use animal byproducts.
Oh, no. You see, we're privately funded, mostly by family-oriented business investors. The call I received earlier directly related to your proposal. We have certain standards. A mission statement, so to speak, and well, we cannot and do not involve ourselves with gaming associations.
Gaming?
Gambling. Well, both of these tribes operate casinos. My associates are vehemently opposed to gambling and feel that we can't back individuals affiliated with the gaming industry.
I'm confused.
Look, our church plays bingo on Saturday nights. I mean, what's the moral issue?
People just don't seem to be able to control themselves. They get addicted and carried away with gambling.
Unfortunately, that's true, but I also see posters prominently displayed on your walls of hotels and restaurants that you've helped fund that sell alcohol and cigarettes. Now, isn't it true that people become addicted to those things as well?
Yes, people can be very self-abusive. That's unfortunate.
So what do you see as the difference? I mean, if we allow people their own choices...
It's just entertainment. I mean, it's more healthy than drinking and smoking.
We have seen fathers of respectable families become addicted to gambling. They get their paycheck from work, hard-earned money, and then blow it at these Indian casinos. And then guess what? they can't feed their families. And as I said, we are a family-oriented organization.
Okay, let's talk about families. For many years, many American Indian families haven't been able to feed their children. I mean, our own father, for example, wasn't allowed to vote as a young man because he was considered a savage. Try to get a job with that attitude toward you.
Then the government ripped us away from him. We were adopted out because our parents lived in poverty on the reservation and couldn't feed us. And we can't help them now. But others can survive. They can keep their families.
Mr. Douglas, the point is, what does that have to do with your firm funding our cosmetics business?
It's your people and the damn casinos that caused the problem.
No, I think the problem is that you and your firm aren't making the money and our people are.
I think this meeting is over. My associates and I have made our decision.
I think you and your associates are racists and hypocrites.
Oh, ow! God damn you! You stupid little Indian bitch!
Vic!
I want to support your business, but I don't like bailing my wife out of jail.
Mom's home!
Mom!
Where were you?
What happened?
Nothing happened.
Everything's fine. I'm okay.
But where? We were so frightened.
Courtney, come on. Derek's got a baseball game. We'll discuss this later. What's that?
What?
Your jersey.
We're the Indians.
There's a pro sports team with a logo just like it.
You are not playing ball on that young man, Vicky. What the hell were you thinking?
She wasn't there. I was the one who took him to tryouts.
It's the best team. My friends are on it.
Honey, what you have on your shirt is a cartoon picture of an Indian person. It makes us look less than human. Look at him. He's got a beet red face and big buck teeth. We don't look like that, do we? It hurts us. It hurts your mommy and your daddy and all of us.
But it's the best team.
Come on. I'll take care of that.
Daddy, wait. What are you going to do?
Sweetheart, it'll be okay. Don't worry.
Sorry.
It's all right. Steve will take care of it. Look, guys, I'm resigning from the business.
What? No.
Come on, I'm just a mom. I don't have an education. I react from my gut. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna give you the recipes.
Vic, look, I'm glad you did what you did yesterday. That man called me a bitch. Come on, it was just like the old days.
You really mean that?
Yes. Except the old days, he got sent to the principal's office instead of to jail.
Yeah. I feel like it's us against the world.
Oh, come on, you guys. We've seen three people, three complete idiots. I know this thing can work.
How long before you have to tell the other job?
A week.
Hi, Mom. Dad rented us a new video game.
Wing Commander Proxy.
Oh, so what happened?
They switched them with another kid. I wanted them to abolish the logo, but that's another battle. Mm. Vic, we need to talk.
Where's this?
They raised the property tax.
Can they just do that?
Yeah.
Oh, this is a lot of money.
You know, Karen said something very weird to me today.
What'd she say?
She said...
Mom, Cody got wiped out. She won't let me have my turn.
Tell the whole story, Derek. You were bumping me so I couldn't play. I get another turn.
I didn't bump her off purpose.
Hey, work it out, you two.
Look, if you can't stop arguing, timeouts for you both, and no sleep over at Tracy's, Courtney.
Fine, let's just start over.
Okay, but I go first.
So what did Karen say that was so weird?
She said, since Tanya and I are both out of work, it's a good thing our foster mom willed us this house.
What's so weird about that?
Did you tell your sisters there's a second mortgage I've been paying every month, as well as insurance and property tax?
No, why should I? This has been our home and our kids. Karen and Tanya haven't lived here.
Well, they live here now. Vicky, I'm working my butt off. I could use some help. We don't have the money to pay the bill. Fact, we can barely pay the upkeep of this house. Now, you know we could never have afforded a place this large if you hadn't inherited it. I can't support the lot of us, not by myself.
Fine, I'll go back to work. The restaurant will take me back.
No, you're not going back to work.
Hey, swallow your pride, Steve.
Vicky, why don't you swallow yours? You're afraid to ask your sisters for some rent and utility money. That's stupid. Karen's got a job offer. And Tanya, she could do something.
We are trying to start a business, and you know that.
Yes, and I've been supportive, and I will continue to be supportive. However, dreams do not pay bills.
What would have happened if Karen and Tanya hadn't come back? Wouldn't you and I still owe this money?
Reality check, Vicky. This house is in your names. If I should disappear tomorrow, the three of you would have to carry the expenses or lose this place.
Courtney, answer that phone! Do not talk to me about disappearing.
Well, I think I need to disappear right now. It's not just a property tax, Vicky. Here, take a look for yourself.
Steve, wait, where are you going?
Someplace where nobody can find me.
That was middle school. We missed my test.
What test? Oh, honey, your entrance exam.
It was this morning. Dad was picking you up.
What did they say? I'm sure you could make it up.
They said it was irresponsible to not call and to not show up.
Honey, please, don't worry. I will call them. I will take care of it.
Dad told us what happened. Are you going to tell them you were in jail?
Courtney, listen. Mommy made a mistake. I should never have hit another person. But I'm not ashamed that I stood up against racism and bigotry.
But don't tell them you were in jail, okay?
Okay.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, it's fine. Where are you off to?
To drive over to Craig's to see his plants. I'll be back around 9. Is that okay?
Oh, yeah.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Enjoy.
Okay.
Bye.
Mom, you won't believe it. Take a look at this. Isn't she gorgeous?
Wow, where are you going?
I have a date.
Mark?
No.
Mark would pee in his pants if we saw her like that.
Courtney, it's someone you don't know.
I'm 32 and single, and I love exotic women.
Not that email guy.
Look, we're meeting in a restaurant. It'll be safe. It's a public place.
Oh, Tanya.
What? We talked to each other for a long time, and he seems like a really nice guy.
Do you even know what he looks like?
Kind of. We describe each other. He's wearing a navy blue blazer.
Oh, well, now I feel better.
Come on, Mom. I'm a big girl. I won't be too late. Bye.
Bye, have fun, I guess. When's Tracy's mom picking me up?
Oh, right now. Did you pack a backpack?
Yeah, my overnight bag on the table.
Okay, I gotta get Derek's too.
Derek's?
They called and invited him to play with Nick.
No, I'm not going over there with him, Mom. He ruins everything.
Courtney, just stop it. Stop it now.
But Mom, you don't understand. He breaks Tracy's things and he ruins our stuff. He and Nick will spy on us.
Why is everybody complaining about something? Derek, let's go. Turn the video off. Down here now.
Please, Mom.
Courtney, stop it. Not one word out of you. You understand?
Get away from me. You're so disgusting.
Here, come on. Tracy's mom is waiting. Let's go. I'll pick you up tomorrow. Bye.
All yours?
Yep. I come up here a lot just to sit and think and clear my head. It's cheaper than therapy.
Well, it's beautiful, and I owe you an apology. I didn't believe you when you told me about it.
Here it is. California lilac. Purple cone flowers back there.
Hey, can you hold this? Thanks.
Take as much as you want. So what do you use the cone flower for?
It's in most of Dad's recipes, so I read up on it. It's incredible. It has this enzyme in it called echinacea, like a natural antibiotic. You can take it like a preventative medicine for colds and flus, and in our product, we'll use it as a healing agent for skin and hair.
That's fascinating.
Yeah, it is fascinating.
I'm fascinated by you. I'm sorry.
It's not your fault.
Well, what then? Is it Tanya? I mean,
no,
what is...
No. I'm just gonna be honest with you.
Please.
I like you a lot, and you're very attractive, but I'm...
What?
Well, I made a choice a long time ago.
A choice?
You're looking at probably the only 30-year-old virgin in the state.
Virgin. Mm-hmm. Virgin. Now that's cool. That's totally cool.
What did you think I would... Oh, no!
I thought that maybe... I'm sorry.
No, I mean, I know it's a weird thing to bring up, but... I've just found it makes dating so difficult, you know? I mean, like, if I hold hands with a guy or give him a kiss on the cheek, I get accused of leading him on. And I usually get one of two responses from guys. Either A, they don't believe me and try to score anyway, or B, they never call back. So I'm just, you know, a little gun-shy.
Well, I think the solution is simple. I'll just have to marry you.
I like the wine. Good choice.
Thanks. Have you ever been to a wine tasting?
Mm-mm. No, never.
You're kidding. I'll have to take you. It's great. Did I tell you, you look absolutely beautiful?
Yes, 5 times. Thank you again.
That shows I really meant it. So tell me about your background. I'm intrigued by Native American culture.
I think I'd rather talk about wine tasting.
You some flowers, but I felt silly carrying them into the restaurant. I didn't know if you would feel embarrassed.
No, I wouldn't have. I love flowers.
Well, they're up in my apartment. Why don't you just come up, just for a moment? I'd really like to give them to you.
I don't know.
Come on, I'll put some coffee out. I don't think you should drive just yet.
I'm okay to drive.
Yeah, I know you're okay. Come on, just for a moment, then I'll bring you back to your car. Enter, my princess.
You know what? I think I'll take a rain check on the coffee, maybe next time.
I just realized I called you my little princess. You know, maybe I should have said my little Pocahontas.
Get off me! Get off!
Hey, you're not acting like a princess. Pocahontas was a princess now, wasn't she, huh?
Yeah.
where is everybody?
Gosh.
Hello. This is Karen Lewis. What? Okay, Valley Presbyterian? Yeah, we'll be right there. Oh my God.
What's wrong?
That was the hospital. Tanya's hurt.
What?
Who was on the phone?
Come on, we gotta go.
What happened to you?
Come on, we gotta go.
What's going on? What happened?
Is she okay?
Oh, he beat her up pretty bad. But she's gonna be okay, considering.
Mark, did he rape her?
No.
Did they arrest him?
Well, the police are working on it.
How did you get here before us?
Well, they said they kept calling your home number, but no one was answering. So they just started going down her address book, and I was the first one that picked up. They gave her a sedative, but you can go on in.
Thanks for being here.
Doctor, this is her family. I filled them in a little bit.
I'm Dr. Baker.
Doctor.
The police just left. Now, they got her statement. They put out an APB on the suspect. Unfortunately, he got away before anyone got a look at the license plate. Now, physically, she's only bruised. No concussion, no broken bones. But she will be sore for a while, and I've already put in a prescription for some pain medication.
Oh, sissy.
From the looks of it, she put up a pretty good fight. Now, no one mentioned anything about insurance. Do you know who the responsible party is?
I am. I'm her brother-in-law.
Great. We just need you to go downstairs and fill out some papers in the financial department. And right now, I think we need to just let her rest. A counselor spoke with her earlier tonight and is coming back tomorrow.
A counselor?
It's just routine. She might want to talk to somebody about the attack. Right?
Excuse me, doctor.
Yes?
Would it be all right if we light some sage in there?
Well, there's no smoking in the rooms, but there's a cafeteria way.
It's not smoking, it's ceremonial.
Ceremonial?
We'd like to pray.
It's part of our culture.
It's very important to us, doctor.
Let me call down and see what I can do, all right?
Thank you. You've been drinking.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Really?
Yeah, I'm really, really sorry.
You look like hell.
Well, you're in luck. Since there's no oxygen in use on this floor, they okayed it. Just don't disturb the other patients, okay?
Thank you very much.
Kashila Hateatopa La Chiakuta Ahitumwa Le Wakaja Akiayo which is Annie. I can hear Kayo. Was a key, I yo. On Kayo, Ton Kashila. Name Hunyelo.
Lord God, our Creator, Creator of all things, we lift up your daughter, Tanya. We ask for healing, healing of both body and soul. We ask for peace. We ask for protection. And we ask for forgiveness. God, I especially ask for forgiveness. Amen.
That's what we know as of this morning.
So basically, you found nothing.
We'll be in touch with you as soon as there are any new developments. Feel free to call us. Tanya has the number.
Just let me get my hands on the guy.
Excuse me. I'm Kimber Green. I'm a counselor with the crisis team here at the hospital. They called me when Tanya was brought in last night. Do you have a moment?
Of course.
Please.
Tanya's experienced a tremendous shock and loss of control. And now, this can be very difficult for family members, especially men. I mean, it's only natural that you would want to protect the women in your lives. However, I need to caution you that more violence at this point is liable to traumatize Tanya further. So I encourage you to love her and support her, but let the police do their job in catching this guy, okay?
You're right. Thank you. Listen, why don't you girls go in on him with Tanya, and Mark and I'll come back a little later after we've had a cup of coffee.
Okay. Thank you.
Would you care to join us?
Oh, thank you. I will.
Please.
Hello.
Knock, knock.
What's so big? You have lots of people who love you.
Yes.
And a niece and nephew who need art lessons.
Oh, we love you, Auntie Tanya.
Yeah.
Please come home soon.
How you feeling, babes?
Fine.
Are the drugs good?
Yeah. Made me forget how stupid I am.
Oh. Cece, don't even say that.
Vicky tried to warn me.
I just thought he was gonna be a nerd.
You know what I dreamed about last night?
Hmm.
Remember the first time I saw a Wizard of Oz?
You made us both sleep with you.
Oh, the smallest damn bed, your elbows in me all night.
They can't find him. Fake address, fake apartment, fake phone number. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I screwed up.
And all the animals, except Coyote, of course, helped Grandmother Spider carry that ball of light until it squeezed out into the world and bounced into the sky. It is said that from that day on, whenever Grandmother Spider would spin her web, the shape of the sun would be right at the center.
But what happened to Coyote?
Coyote is cool. He's a trickster.
Well, it doesn't really say, but knowing Coyote, he'll be back to bother Grandmother Spider another time. Good night, honey.
Mommy, don't leave.
Oh, sweetie, you need to go to sleep. Well, so do I. Come on, give me a hug. I love you. Good night. Good night, Court.
Good night. Mom, will the Batman who hurt Tanya come here?
Oh, no, honey. The police are looking for him. They're gonna put him in jail for a long time.
I'm scared.
What if they can't find him?
Can I sleep with you and Daddy tonight?
Oh, no, honey. Not tonight. Good night.
Derek, you can come and sleep with me.
I love you both.
Night, Mom.
Good night.
Hi, hon.
Kids asleep?
Yeah, they're actually sleeping in the same bed tonight.
We gonna talk about what happened?
Well, the police can't find him.
I don't mean Tanya.
Steve, you walked out. I didn't know where you were.
I took a walk.
You were mad about the bills. You blamed me. And then I looked in the mirror.
What did you see in the mirror?
A 33-year-old mother of two. Kind of fat. Kind of plain. Bags under my eyes. Someone who doesn't wear garters for her husband.
Vicky, I wanted you to wear garters because I happen to like the way you look. When I look at you, I see sexy. I see beautiful.
Steve, I just don't feel very good about myself right now.
So drinking's gonna solve that?
No. No, I'm not gonna drink anymore. I'm actually gonna listen to you on that one.
I don't want it to be because I asked you to. I want it to be because you like yourself enough not to do it.
And it is. Steve, I'm not stupid and I'm not a drunk. I realize I do need to take it seriously, though, before it does become a problem.
You mean that?
Yeah. Honest Injun. Hey, I'm gonna start work tomorrow. The restaurant took me back.
What about the kids?
I'm just gonna do breakfast and lunch. I'll be home by 3. Let me do this for a while. I know we can make it work. Please.
Okay. One condition.
What's that?
Believe me when I say I love you and think you're beautiful.
Outside the window.
The bad man's coming.
The bad man isn't coming, son.
Can we sleep with you tonight, just this once?
Please.
All right. But just for tonight. Come in.
Okay.
Oh, make room for Daddy.
Okay.
And there's no bad man coming.
Okay.
Yeah.
Vicky, here is some rent money, and I really wish you would have told me sooner.
Thanks for understanding.
Police called. They found him.
Really?
Where?
Nevada.
They're bringing him home now. And I'm going to press charges.
Good for you, sweetie.
Damn right you are.
You know what? I'm gonna call the people in Chicago tomorrow. So much for dreams. Back to reality.
No. No. Sit down. I did a lot of thinking while I was in the hospital.
That happens on Demerol.
Stop it, Vicky. I'm serious. I was the last one to really believe in this idea. But now it's something I can't let go of. Karen filled me in. Steve's right. We can all take jobs to help with the bills. But we can't give up on this. We just can't give up on this. We're a team. Family. And all those people who put us down, they can all just go to hell. I made a phone call.
Says, welcome to the Viejas Indian Reservation. By entering the reservation, you are consenting to submission to the laws and regulations of the Viejas Band of Mission Indians under the authority of Viejas Tribal Laws and Customs. And it's signed Viejas Tribal Council.
Is this how you remember the reservation?
Yeah, sort of.
Wow. It's bigger than I ever expected.
There are lots of cars. So is this where the meeting is?
No. It's at the tribal office.
It's down the street a ways. Wow.
Guys, I can't do this.
Why? All they can do is say no.
They made the appointment. They must be interested a little.
What if they ask us why we never came back, huh? What if they're all like that woman at the powwow and think we're just coming back for the casino money?
The woman at the powwow was nobody. Our father died. The entire tribe must know that.
That's no excuse for not coming back. Besides, we don't have those stupid numbers.
Did they ask for numbers when you called, Tanya?
No, just our paperwork. You and Karen filled it out.
Don't you think they would have called if there was a problem?
Maybe they just want us to come back so they could reprimand us to our face. Have you ever thought about that?
Well, then we can take it.
Well, maybe you can take it, Vicky. But I can't. I can't go back there. I can't go again. I'm going home.
No. Karen, we can't turn back now. We've been walking away from stuff for 200 years.
Would you stop it already with that activist political crap? I didn't walk away. You told me I had to work twice as hard because I was Indian, and I did.
I got my degree. You think that was easy?
Hey, this isn't about the last 200 years. This is about the last 26 years. It's how long we've been walking away.
I'm sorry, but I won't turn back. Look, I'm scared too. Come here. Give me your hand, Karen. Come on. Let's pray. Oh, dear God, heavenly creator. God, I don't even know what to say right now.
God, I'm scared and confused. Just please give us strength.
Help us to understand.
Just give us the strength that our ancestors had who went before us.
Sisters?
Hi, I'm Joanne. Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hi.
Hi. We have an appointment.
Oh, yes, just a moment. Yes, the Lewis family's in the lobby. Thanks. Someone will be right with you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks.
Hello. Hello. Hi. I'm Charlie. My name is Charlie Chaffa.
Hi.
Hi. Chairman Pico asked me to come here to show you around before the meeting, okay? Of course, this is our tribal building, and out there you've seen our community center. And right over here is our museum, and I want to show you, so follow me. Yeah, I'm so glad to hear that you was coming. You know, your father and I are cousins.
Wait a minute, we're related?
Oh, yeah, you have a slew of relatives here, and cousins, and all kinds of family, and, you know, they all remember you. They've known you since you were little tykes, you know, before they took you away. Anyway, this just came in last night. This was found in someone's basement. This is a rancher's accounting of how many Indians they killed when they stole the land here. And you know, the government, of course, supplied the ammunition. Yeah, you ought to come back here and check everything out here. There's all kinds of stuff to see here, you know, when you get some time and everything. But I think right now, Chairman Pico wants to see you, so I'll take you back over that way.
Mr. Chaffa.
Well, call me Charlie.
Charlie. Look, do we need numbers?
Oh, the roll numbers issued by the government?
To be recognized as part of the tribe?
Hell no. In my opinion, roll numbers is the government's way of terminating us. You know, like if we don't have a number, they can't count us. They can't count us, then we don't exist. You know, and every time we try to apply for a roll number, they just keep us waiting and waiting and waiting. Yeah, we don't need any numbers. We're family here. We know who you are. And that's better than any roll number, right?
Right.
Hey, I brought you a family.
Thanks, Charlie.
Thanks.
All right, hey, I'll see you ladies later, okay?
Bye, Charlie. Bye.
Come in. Come in. Let's see, it's Karen, right?
Yes, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. We actually met a long time ago. You were too young to remember. Have a seat. And
I'm Vicky, Big Hawk.
Big Hawk. Is that a married name?
Yes.
Crow or Sue?
It's Sue.
All right. And you're the baby. It's Tanya, right? Well, it's been a long time. It's good to see you come home.
Thank you.
So what do you think of the museum?
Oh, it's great.
We hope to come back.
Well, we have a lot of work to do yet. We're still trying to recover artifacts and sacred items from all the museums around the state. They belong here. First of all, let me congratulate you. I see you put a lot of thought into your proposal. Our tribe has just created a small business division. We've been living in a communal environment for so long, it's hard to think in terms of ownership. But we believe it's imperative now. And you'll be excellent role models for the rest of the tribe. Excuse me.
It's Howard. Says it's an emergency at the casino. He insisted that I buzz you.
All right, I'll take it. Howard, what's going on? Did you call security? Federal or state? No, we won that appeal long ago. Okay, I'll be down there as soon as I can. Be sure and call Jerry, okay? Thanks. I'm sorry about that, but the feds just showed up and they want to shut down the casino.
Is that legal?
Well, they can try, but we've been dealing with the feds for 100 years. We can handle them now. I'm only sorry I can't visit with you longer. Our tribe realizes the importance of what you're trying to do. Joanne can answer any questions you have about the loan. She will want you to sign the agreement. It's based on a line of credit. Judging from your assets, you've been awarded $50,000. Repayment terms begin in 1 year. It's all in there. So, congratulations, good luck, and keep us posted on your progress. Joanna can put you in touch with our marketing gal down at the casino. She'd like to carry your line as soon as it's ready for distribution. I think the casinos at Barona and Sequan would like to do the same.
Thank you.
No, thank you. And don't forget to stop by Joanne's desk on the way out. Wish me luck. Bye.
Good luck.
$50,000.
Okay, you guys, we have everything but the name.
I feel like we're so close.
Native.
Natural.
Naturals. That's it.
Hello?
Hey, I say, is anybody home?
Hey, you guys. Hi. Hey. Here, let me help you with this.
Hey, a nice little soda for the party and something for Miss Karen.
That would be calendula and California lilac.
Thank you so much.
Mark, would you come help me put these in the ice chest?
Yeah, sure.
I washed it out. So do we put the drinks or the ice in first?
Drinks.
Mark, I need to talk to you.
What? I didn't get the right brand?
No. They're great. Perfect. I've been stupid.
Don't start that again. He's in jail. You weren't stupid.
No, not about that. About you. I want to apologize. Start over.
So I was thinking.
So was I.
Since we're going to be working together, I think that I should...
Marry me.
No.
No.
Help you start your own business so you make more actual profit.
That would be my second choice.
Of course it would. Seriously, maybe we could talk about it over dinner. You know, a real date?
No, sorry. I'm going to be busy with my new business. You're going to have to wait 2 weeks.
Hey, Craig. Could you help me set these tables up outside, please?
Sure, I can help.
Anybody seen Vicky?
You know, I haven't seen her all afternoon.
Hounding her, better watch it. Eric, hey, what's up? How you doing? Marley, good to see you. Gene, what's up? Roger, hey. Oh, we got some lovely ladies over here. Dawn, say hi to the camera, please. Margarita, hi.
Whoa. Hi, Mommy.
Oh, Derek, that's my piece of cake. Give it back.
Cake, you haven't had dinner yet. Go put the cake away.
Vicky, you look great.
Thanks, honey.
Say hi to the camera.
Whoa. Steve, actually, could you put the camera down? I have a crisis in the kitchen, and I need you to come look at something right away.
Oh, bummer. What is it now?
Well, let me show you.
Hey, guys.
Whoa, look at me.
Great outfit. Here, somebody brought this to the party.
Oh, thanks. Oh,
can we get something to eat? I'm not sorry.
Come on, I need to show you this. Vicky, you look stunning. Wow.
Thank you.
Oh, would you like me to take that, maybe?
Yeah.
No, actually, I have the perfect place for it. Come on.
What is it this time? Stove again, huh?
No, just this.
Oh, my God.
Mom, Dad, Derek spilled Coke everywhere. It's even on the ceiling. Karen told me to get you and a mop fast.
It was an accident.
No, it wasn't. You shook it up first to see if it would explode.
Did not!
Okay, here, take this. I'll take this. We'll go wipe it up. Come on.
Hey, wait a minute.
Don't worry. I'm not going very far. I'll catch you later.
Hoka, hey!
We would like to thank all of you. We could never have accomplished this business venture without the tribal support and the support of our family. Thank you.
We at Naturally Native are committed to filling orders from retailers all over the country, including casino gift shops and exclusive health spas.
We even received inquiries from Walmart.
I'm also pleased to announce these ladies have agreed to conduct a workshop on self-employment tonight at the Cultural Center. They need to hire a few more employees, and we're giving preference to tribal members. We are also honored to have two elders who have come aboard to act as consultants. And lastly, we are very happy to welcome back Karen, Vicky, and Tanya and their extended family back to the community. As my grandfather used to say, we know where we come from, we know where we're going. It's the in-between that's difficult. Speaking of in-between, let's eat.
At the press conference.
I was looking for something I wanted to show you. This is your grandpa, and this is your grandma on your dad's side.
Can I see Mom?
Oh, sure, honey. Courtney. These are your great-grandparents.
Wow. I didn't even know I had any.
Welcome home.
Keeper of visions, of ancestors' dreams.